Torchy! Torchy! Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
King Dithers, the king of Topsy-Turvyland, was riding in his coach. But Daffy the donkey wasn't pulling it fast because it was very hot.
I wish I could find a nice shady tree to sit under.
Oh, well, you can't sit under a tree. I want to go to Fruit Town and invite Torchy and all the other toys who live there to come to my palace for tea this afternoon.
It's not right for a king to go out and invite toys to his palace. You should send them all a proper invitation.
Oh, well, it would take me too long.
Then you should write one big invitation and nail it on a tree. Then all the toys would see it. When I lived on Earth and belonged to a naughty boy called Jeffrey, he used to stick an invitation in his window and invite everybody in the road.
Yes, I thought all donkeys were donkeys. But you're quite clever for a donkey. Yes, well, you can take me back to the palace after all, and I'll write a big invitation and nail it to a tree.
The king returned to his palace and sat on the throne.
Ah, I've got a big piece of paper, and I'll write the invitation at once. Daffy, where's my golden pen?
I don't know.
Well, I was using it to write a letter yesterday. Oh, maybe I've left it in the milk. I mean the ink.
Did you give it to the pelican bird?
Yes. Of course I did. Oh, how dithery I am not to remember. Where's the pelican?
I'm coming. I can't walk very fast on flat feet.
Yes. There you are. Yes. I want my paintbrush. I mean my fountain pen. I want to paint a letter. Okay, write a letter.
It's in my beak.
And when I've written it, Polycan, you can hang it on a tree for me.
What have you got in your hand?
An invitation to King Dither's birthday party.
I love parties. Can I come too?
Everybody in Topsy-Turvyland can come.
How wonderful. I'll go and tell Torchy.
Torchy and Flopsy were picking some cream buns from the cream bun tree.
Why, Flopsy, there's a funny-looking tree over there. I've never noticed it before. Oh, goody, goody, it's a toffee apple tree. Let's make ourselves sick eating them.
It's lovely to live here, isn't it?
In Topsy-Turvyland, you can do whatever you want. If you don't eat your greens, then there aren't any sins, and no one says that you can't. In Topsy-Turvyland, where icing sugar is snow, and there's only one rule that
that you don't go to school, and no one ever says no. Oh no one ever says no. Topsy Turvy, everything's front to back. There's no such thing as punishments, and no such thing as a smack. In topsy-turvy land, you can do whatever you please. We have lemonade flowers, you can drink them for hours, and cream buns all grow on trees. In topsy-turvy land, you can play all day in the sun. You don't need a bed, you can stay up instead, and all you do is have fun, 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 and all you do is have fun. Topsy-turvy, everything's upside down. Animals talk and toys can walk in a topsy-turvy town.
Torchy!
What's the matter, Pom Pom? Why are you so excited?
King Dithers has invited us to his birthday party.
How lovely! We'll have to buy him a pickle pobble.
I'm going to give him a crispy, crunchy bone.
I'll make him a pair of curtains for his bedroom.
And I'll bake a birthday cake. Let's go home and make the presents immediately.
Flopsy sat in her cherry cottage and sewed two beautiful curtains. Pom Pom dug up a large juicy bone.
I've a good mind to eat it myself. But I'd better not.
And of course Torchy baked a cake.
This is going to be the best birthday cake King Dithers has ever had. Mmm, it smells delicious. I'm sure it must be ready. I'll open the oven and take it out. Who's that?
It's Pom Pom the Poodle. I want to show you the present I've got for King Dithers.
Well, come in. I've just taken out the cake I've baked and look what's happened to it.
It's as flat as a pancake. It feels like shoe leather.
How awful. What can have gone wrong? I put in flour and eggs and butter and sugar.
And did you put in baking powder?
No, I didn't.
Chase a cat around a tree. You must always use baking powder in a cake.
What does it do?
It makes the cake rise.
How clever of you to know that, Pom Pom. Have you got any baking powder for me?
No, but Flopsy has. I'll go and bring you the tin.
Flopsy went to her cupboard and gave the poodle a tin of baking powder.
Tell Torchy just to put in one teaspoon, otherwise the cake will get too high.
All right. Bye-bye now. Here's the baking powder for you, Torchy.
Thank you. And how much do I have to use?
Flopsy didn't tell me, but she said you've got to put in one teaspoon.
How funny. There, I'll put in this wooden spoon instead. And now, I'll put in the whole tin of baking powder as well. Then I'll put it in the oven and have a little rest until it's ready. I can smell my cake cooking and I'm sure it's going to taste wonderful.
Well, I think you should take it out, Torchy. It's been in the oven a long time and you don't want it to get burnt.
I certainly don't. I'll take it out at once.
I wonder if I should put a bow in my hair for the party today.
Oh dear! Pom Pom, come quickly. I must have put in too much baking powder.
What a funny looking cake it is!
And it's so light, I think it's going to blow away! Ooh! It's carrying me up into the air! Well, I never...
Torchy sailed away, swinging backwards and forwards in the air.
I can see the orange peel palace below. And all the toyers are going in to have tea with King Dithers. Oh, dear, I missed the party. If only the wind would stop blowing, the cake might drop. Ooh, I think the wind is stopping. Yes, it is. Whoops!
Well, I hope Torchy manages to get here. Oh dear, I can't have a birthday without a birthday cake.
And you can't be a king without a crown.
Good gracious me. Oh, I forgot to put it on. Oh dear.
I'm here, Your Majesty. Oh, what a terrible time I've had. I'm still dizzy.
Thank goodness you're safe.
Oh, what a lovely cake. But what's the spoon doing in the middle?
Flopsy said we should put a spoon in the cake.
I said a spoon of baking powder, you silly diggle-doggle.
How funny. Whenever I have to take a teaspoon of medicine in water, I always sit in a bath. Yes, now I'll put on my crown, and we can sit down and eat the cake. Daffy, bring in the ginger pop.
In a minute, Your Majesty. It hasn't popped yet.
Well, bring it in as soon as it has. What a lovely party we'll have. Now then, I'll cut my birthday cake. My goodness me. It's my crown. Oh, where's the cake? What have you done with the cake?
You're wearing it by mistake.
Hmm? Oh, good gracious. So I am. I told you I was dithery, didn't I?
You certainly did.
Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
Into the sky on a dark night, you'll see a star shining very brightly. It's Topsy-Turvy Land, and all the toys who used to belong to naughty children live there in a town made of fruit.
In Topsy-Turvy Land, where ice and sugar is snowing, and there's only one rule that you don't go to school, and no one ever says no, oh no.
Torchy lives in this pineapple, and he's the leader of the toys. He has a rocket of his own, and sometimes flies down to Earth.
It's lovely to live in a house of my own, But it's the washing I don't like. Everything takes such a long time to dry. And Fruit Owl looks horrid with all the wet clothes hanging on the line. Yes, the toys have hung their clothes out already. Even Flopsy's finished, and she had more washing than anyone.
I do hope the sun shines brightly and dries my sheets and pillowcases quickly. I'll go and see Pom Pom, and if she hasn't finished her washing, I can help her.
Pom Pom was in her lemon house, looking at the pile of dirty washing on the floor.
Whenever I do my washing, I get wet. And when I get wet, my curls come out. But what a big pile it is. It's very soft. I think I'll lie on it and have a dog nap. Oh, how comfortable it is. I'm so tired. I think I'll have two dog naps.
I can't hear anyone inside Pom Pom's house. Maybe she's finished her washing and gone out. I'll just go inside and have a look. My goodness! Pom Pom hasn't done her washing after all. What a big pile there is on the floor. I'll take it home and put it in my wash tub. Won't Pom Pom be pleased? It's heavy. I hope I can manage.
Flopsy took the washing home and put it in the butt. Pom Pom went away and left all the washing to dry. But then a terrible thing happened. It started to rain. And although on Topsy-Turvy Land it only rains orange juice, well, orange juice is just as wet as water.
Good gracious, it's pouring with rain. The washing will never be dry by tonight. And none of us will have any sheets or pillowcases on the beds. Who is it?
Pillywig the clown and Nina.
Well, come in quickly or you'll get wet. Take off your wet things and sit down.
I can't take off my raincoat. I haven't got anything on underneath.
Where's your suit?
Nina washed it for me. Whoa. I'm so cold.
You'll freeze to death.
It's nothing to laugh at.
I'm not laughing, Pillywig. I'm crying. I always laugh when I cry. Dogs bark, cats meow, and hyenas laugh. We've got to get the washing dry somehow. I'll ask my magic bean to help us.
Torchy pressed the switch on his jacket, and there was a noise like a blue bottle on the windowpane. The light in his hat grew brighter, and it shone out of his house and all the way across Topsy-Turvy Land to the cave in the far mountain. Torchy cycled along the road as quickly as he could on his penny farthing, and soon he reached the cave in the far mountain.
You wait here, Bird, and I'll go inside and see Sparky the dragon. Sparky, where are you?
I am in bed.
What's the matter with you?
I feel ill. I ate something and it disagreed with me, and I've been in bed all day.
You poor thing! What did you eat?
Well, I was making myself a hot pot, but I was so cold that I wanted it to be the very hottest hot pot. So I cooked it over a big coal fire, and then I...
Oh, Sparky, you don't mean to say you ate a hot, hot pot and burned your throat.
No, I didn't. But I ate the fire instead. Oh dear, my breath is so hot. I think I've given myself a temperature.
I think I know why my magic beam sent me here. You'll have to come to Fruit Town and blow on the washing with your hot breath, and then it'll all dry.
Very well. But I'll come straight back home as soon as I've dried your clothes.
When Sparky and Torchy reached the lines of washing, the rain had stopped, but the clothes were still wet.
Now then, Sparky, breathe on them.
Very well, but I've got a terrible cough. Have you any cough drops for me?
No, I haven't, but I've got a big bottle of cough medicine, and I'll go home and get it while you're drying the washing.
Torchy went home and found the medicine on a shelf.
Who's that for?
It's for Sparky. He ate a coal fire, and he's given himself a temperature and a cough.
How terrible! He might get bronchitis.
It's nothing to laugh at.
I know it isn't.
Torchy ran back to give Sparky some cough medicine. And when he reached the lines of washing, he stopped and stared, for it was covered with sooty marks.
It's coal dust. Oh, Sparky, your breath must be black because of the coal you ate.
I'm very sorry, Torchy. I'd better go home to bed. I've not been much use to you, have I?
No, you haven't, but it's not your fault. We'll just have to wash the clothes all over again. Oh, now it's beginning to rain again. Oh, gosh, let's go into my house.
No, thank you. I want to go home to bed. I'm sorry I couldn't help you.
That's all right. I'm afraid you'll have to wear your raincoat a bit longer, Pillywig. Sparky has made the clothes black by mistake. And now it's starting to rain again.
Whatever's the matter with you, Torchy? The clothes aren't black at all. The rain has made them clean. Hooray! And the sun's coming out. Hooray! The clothes will be dry in next to no time. Hooray!
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, Torchy, Torchy,
if you look into the sky on a dark night, you will see one star twinkling more brightly than any of the others. It's Topsy-Turvy Land, where all the toys that used to belong to the naughty children live.
In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can do whatever you want. If you don't eat your greens, then there aren't any scenes, and no one says that you can't. In Topsy-Turvy Land, where icing sugar is snow, and there's only one rule that you don't go to school, and no one ever says no. Oh no, oh no one ever says no. Topsy-turvy, everything's front to back. There's no such thing as punishments, and no such...
Whirly, the humming top, is having a spin outside the cave where he lives. He came to Topsy-Turvy Land on a big wind and never wants to go back to Earth and belong to naughty children anymore.
Hello, Sparky. Will you help me give a party for all the toys who live in Fruitdown?
Goody, goody. Where shall we give the party? These caves are much too dark and gloomy.
They won't be dark if we light lots of candles and have lots of beautiful flowers.
Have you got any candles and flowers?
Spin me round and call me Whirly. Of course I haven't. We must look for some.
Whirly and Sparky walked and walked, but they couldn't find any candles or any flowers. Soon the sun set in the sky, and it grew dark.
My feet are hurting me.
So am I. But
my feet hurt me more than yours do because my feet are bigger. If only we... Why, Wally, look!
What is it?
Over there, through the trees, I can see a light.
Why? So can I. God gracious me! We've found a Christmas tree with candles on!
Let's pick some and take them back to the cave with us.
You leave those candles alone.
Who said that?
I did.
Who are you?
Who do you usually find on the top of a Christmas tree?
A fairy!
Exactly. A fairy. How do you do? Don't you think I'm pretty?
You're very pretty. But why haven't we seen you before?
I only arrived here a few days ago. I belong to a naughty girl called Caroline. She wanted to take off my dress and use it as a duster. But by mistake, she left me near an open window. And a big wind blew me up into the sky until I landed on this twinkling star.
Do come down, fairy, and let us have a look at you.
If you promise to invite me to the party as well, I might let you have some candles after all.
Of course we'll invite you. Come on, Sparky. Let's pick some candles and take them back to the cave.
We've got to find some flowers, too.
You go and look for them, and I'll take the candles to the cave for you.
Thank you very much. We'll come back as quickly as we can. Bye-bye.
Once more, Sparky and Whirly went walking. Deeper and deeper into the woods they wandered, until they lost their way.
I think we'll have to lie down and wait until the morning. We'll never find our way out in the dark.
I wish we hadn't come. I don't like the dark.
Don't be so silly. Oh, what was that?
I don't know. Oh, do come closer to me and let's try to fall asleep.
Soon the two toys fell asleep, and in the morning, when they woke up, they saw a strange thing.
Sparky, wake up. We've found some flowers after all. Look at these wonderful bluebells.
Aren't they beautiful? Let's pick some at once. What a delicious smell. I'm stuck. I can't move my nose away from the floor.
Well, I've never... These flowers aren't bluebells. They're glowbells. Yes, I can see a lump of glue in the middle of each bud. We have to be very careful when we pick them. We don't want to get stuck. Come on, let's take a big bunch home with us.
Well, I never. What a big card. And it's from Whirly, inviting me and all the other toys in Fruit Town to come to a party today. Hooray! I love parties. Flopsy, Pom Pom, Squish, we've been invited to a party.
I love parties.
Where is it?
At Whirly's house.
I'll go and fetch Flopsy. She can't have heard you call her.
Maybe she's in bed.
I'll pull her out if she is. Wake up, Flopsy.
We've been invited to a party!
Torchy and Squish had reached the cave before anyone else, and they were longing for the party to begin.
Can't we eat the cakes now?
Of course not. We must wait for the others. Now do excuse me while I go and make some more lemonade.
Doesn't it look beautiful here? What lovely flowers! How soft the petals are. Oh, Squish, I am hungry. I'm sure Whirly wouldn't mind if I ate just one cream bun.
You'd better put it back. I can hear him coming.
Oh, I can't put it back. It's stuck to my fingers.
No. What's going on? Aha! So you wanted to try and eat a cream bunny? I caught you at it, didn't I?
What's magic about bluebells?
They're not bluebells. They're gluebells. Now, for goodness sake, sit down and behave yourself.
What fun to have sticky flowers. I'm sure we could play a wonderful trick with them.
Hello, everybody. I hope I'm not too late for the party.
Where's Flopsy?
She's outside the cave. She won't come in because she's wearing a nightdress.
Never mind. Why don't you take her a bunch of flowers as a surprise?
Ooh, that's a good idea. What a lovely smell.
There's some paper behind you.
Oh, so there is. Now then, I'll take a big sheet of paper and slip a lamppost. The paper's stuck to my nose. Get off! I can't push the paper away.
I can't go to the party in my nightdress. Oh, I'm so miserable.
Don't be miserable, Flopsy. I'm a fairy, and with my magic wand, I'll grant you a wish.
Oh, how wiggle-woggle! I wish I had a dress just like yours.
Very well. Close your eyes and count to five.
One, two, three, four, five. Oh, how lovely! Oh, thank you for my lovely party dress. Now we could be little foggles together.
Toys sat round the table to begin the party.
I'm very glad you all came here today, and I hope you have lots of fun.
And I'd like to thank Fairy for giving me this wiggle-woggle dress. Here are, Fairy. I want to give you a present of some flowers.
Ooh, what's happened? Help! Help! I can't see a thing. Ooh.
Poor old fairy. You'll have to dip your head in water before we can pull off the bluebells.
Oh, dear. Every time I try to be kind, something goes wrong. What a sickle-sockle doll I am.
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my
I switch, see my bulbs start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, 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 see my bulbs start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
I'm sure you haven't seen a bridge made of a banana before. That's because you haven't been to Topsy-Turvy Land. All the toys that used to belong to naughty children live there. And one of the toys comes from America. There he is now. It's Squish, the space boy with a water pistol.
I was gonna go fishing today, but I've changed my mind because it's not very exciting. Maybe I'll go and find Pillywig and Ina and ask them to play with me.
Pillywig and Ina were in the playground, and Ina was knitting as usual.
I do wish you'd hurry up and finish that knitting. I thought it was going to be a scarf for my tooth, but it looks more like a pullover.
It is a pullover. How clever of you to know. Come here, Pillywig, and let me measure you. My goodness, your suit is looking very old and untidy. But never mind, you'll soon be able to wear this instead.
Oh, Ina, I'm so glad I found you.
And I'm glad I found you. I was very sad by myself. In fact, I was so sad that I cried all the time.
Hi, Pillywig. Hi, Ina. You laughing as usual?
Of course. Dogs bark, cats meow, and hyenas laugh.
Well, stop laughing and come and play with me.
No, thank you. Ina's knitting me a pullover, and I want her to finish it today.
Stick them up or I'll squirt you with my water pistol.
No, don't. Don't squirt water at me or I'll get wet.
Well, that'll serve you right. Now I'm going to squish the trigger and the water will squish out. Oh, well, what's happened?
You've got no water in your water pistol.
How awful. Well, I better go and find some water right away.
What a horrid toy he is. I hope he doesn't find any water.
Oh, so do I.
Grish went to Fru Town and found Torchy and Pom Pom cleaning the penny farthing bicycle.
Have you any fresh water for me to put in my water pistol?
No, I haven't. And even if I had, I wouldn't give it to you because you're always squirting that water pistol at me.
Okay, then. I'll find some on my own.
Squish went into the magic wood and looked everywhere for fresh water.
Gee, I can't find any water. What's the good of having a water pistol if you can't use it?
Aww.
Ooh, that sounds like Daffy, the donkey. Yes, I can see him coming down the road. Maybe he can help me. Hi, Daffy. Do you know where I can get some fresh water?
No, I don't. There isn't any on Topsy-Turvy Land. Everybody drinks orange juice and lemonade.
There must be fresh water here. Maybe you've forgotten.
Aww. What a rude thing to say. Elephants forget, but donkeys always remember.
Well, I'll go and ask King Dithers. I'll climb into the coach and you can take me to see him.
Don't you dare climb in the king's coach.
Oh, be quiet, Daffy. Giddy up and take me to the palace.
Slowly, Daffy trotted along the road and Squish fell asleep.
Fancy telling me what to do. I don't take orders from anyone except the king. I'll pull the coach over every stone I can find. That'll wake Squish up.
Hey, what was that? Oh, be careful, Daffy. Gee, you'll shake my head off if you're not careful.
The king was polishing his crown with a boot brush.
Oh, my goodness. The more I polish, the dirtier it gets.
That's because you're using a boot brush with black polish on.
Oh, so I am. Oh, aren't I, Dithery? What do you want, Squish?
I want some water for my water pistol.
Well, you'd better find a washing well. A wishing well. No. Oh, dear. I mean, a wishing well. Oh, good gracious me, what do I mean?
Do you mean a wishing well?
Yes, that's right. Yes. And then, when you find it, you'll find fresh water there.
Oh, gee, thanks very much. Is the well in the palace gardens?
Oh, no. Of course it is.
I don't know what you mean.
I'm sorry, Squish. I'm more absent-minded than usual. Why, when I got up this morning, I drank my shaving water and shaved myself with the tea. For I am King Dithers, the dithery king, oh, dithery, dithery ding. I often go out when I want to go in. There's no one as silly as me. For I often smile when I ought to frown. And I stand up when I want to sit down. For I am King Dithers, the dithery king, oh, dithery, dithery dee. I drink with a knife and I eat with a spoon. There's no one as silly as me. I haven't a country, I haven't a town. And I'll admit I've lost me crown. And I've even gone out in my dressing gown. I'm Dithers, the dithery king. Why, Squish has disappeared. He must have gone to look for the wishing well by himself.
I couldn't find the well in the palace garden, so I'm looking in the wood again. Why? What's that funny-looking thing over there? Gee, I bet this is the well. Are you the wishing well? Wishing well? Have you any fresh water down there? Down there. Oh, boy, I can see fresh water at the bottom. Oh, how can I reach it? I know. I'll climb into this bucket and go right down to the bottom. I sure am clever. It's very dark down here, but at least I found some fresh water for my pistol. Now I'll fill it up, and then I'll climb out. There, now it's filled. But how can I get out? Oh, I'll never be able to reach the top, and there's no one to pull me up in the bucket. Oh, gee, how stupid I am. Help! Help! Will somebody save me? Help! Help! Will somebody save me?
Don't worry, Squish. I'm here now. I'll turn the handle and pull the bucket up.
It's no good, Torchy. The chain is broken.
Oh, dear. Never mind. I'll take the chain off the roller and lower it to you.
Okay. Hurry up, Torchy. Torchy. It's cold down here. Oh, heck, I can't reach it. Can't you stretch over a bit more, Torchy?
Oh, I'm not sure. There, will that do?
I still can't reach it. A bit lower, Torchy.
All right, Now I've fallen in the bucket, and there's no one to get us out.
Oh, you'd better shine your magic beam.
Oh, I'd quite forgotten about it.
There was a noise like a blue bottle on the window pane, and Torchy's magic beam shone out of the well and all the way to the playground.
I've finished your pullover now, Pillywig. So you'd better go and put it on.
Oh, it looks too long for me.
Of course it isn't. Put it on at once.
Why? Oh, there's a light on it. Well, I never. It's Torchy's magic beam. Oh, that means he's in trouble. I better follow the light and see where it leads me. And I better take this pullover as well, because the light was shining onto it.
Pillywig followed the light to the wishing well, and leaning over, saw Torchy and Squish in the bucket.
Your beam shone onto my pullover. What do I have to do with it?
Hold one end of it and throw it down here. Then we can tie it onto the bucket and you can pull us up.
There we are. I'm holding one end of the sleeve. Can you reach the other?
Yes. I'm tying the other sleeve onto the handle of the bucket. It's all ready now. I've tied it on so you can pull us up. Hooray! We'll soon be out of the well.
Thank goodness. I didn't like being down there one bit.
There you are, safe and sound.
Thanks to your pullover, if Ina hadn't made it so long, Squish and I would still have been down the well.
So you would. Well.
Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I'm a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
You If you look out of your window on a dark night, you will see a star that twinkles more brightly than any other. And if you could go closer to it, you would see its topsy-turvy land, where all the toys who used to belong to naughty children live. Look at this big pile of money. It's not for spending, though. It's for eating. And it belongs to Clinker, the money box. There he is now, coming along with a bucket and a shovel.
Lovely grub, lovely grub. I'll shovel myself a bucket full of money and take it home to eat. There's nothing more tasty than a salty sixpence washed in with half a crown.
Hello, Clinker. Can I help you?
No, thank you, Flopsy. Would you like to eat a threepenny bit?
No. I'm not a money box. I'm a rag doll. And I'm stuffed with cotton wool.
And I'm stuffed with money. When I lived on Earth and belonged to Bossy Boots, she never put any money inside me, and I was always hungry. But now that I'm living on Topsy-Turvy Land, I'm so happy.
What'll happen when you've used up all this money?
We've got a money tree. Come along, I'll show you. It's in the magic wood. There you are, Flopsy. The money tree's in front of you.
Oh, how wonderful. I've never seen a tree growing money before.
Well, you see, the roots of this tree are planted in a gold mine.
No wonder you're so happy.
Oh, I am, I am. Let's go to the seaside and play.
Oh, I want to take a bucket and spade with me.
I'll go home and get it for you, and you go to the beach and wait.
All right. But don't be long.
Have you got a bucket and spade for me, Torchy?
No, I haven't, but I'm sure I saw one in the playground. I'll get it for you now.
What about my breakfast?
Oh, you'll have to wait.
Oh, dear. I'm so hungry. I think I'll go for a fly in the sky and see if I can find a worm.
The tingling bird flew in the sky looking for a worm. Flew into the sky holding the worm in his beak. But it wasn't a worm, of course. It was poor Flopsy's stuffy. On and on the tingling bird flew, and soon poor Flopsy had no more stuffing left inside her, for the bird had pulled it all out.
Crying.
I hope nothing's happened to her. Oh, look, she's on the beach and she looks very peculiar. What's happened to you, Flopsy?
My biggle-boggle siggle-soggled. I'm so floppy, I tingled her wiggle-woggle.
Someone's taken away Flopsy's stuffing. Whoever can it be?
Just wait until I catch them.
You needn't wait very long. Look over there.
Wasn't a worm after all. It's Flopsy's stuffing.
Well, I never. It was the tingling bird.
I'm sure he didn't pull out Flopsy's stuffing purposely. It must have been an accident.
He thought it was a wiggle-woggle. Please don't higgle-hoggle him.
Don't worry, Flopsy. I won't punish the tingling bird if it was an accident. But I'm going to make him help me put your stuffing back in.
I think Flopsy should have some extra stuffing as well. I'll go and cut some of Pom Pom's hair. I'll be back soon.
Pom Pom Tom the Poodle was chewing a bone in her lemon house.
I love crispy, crunchy bones. They're so good for my teeth.
May I come in, Pom Pom?
Yes, of course. What do you want?
I want to cut some of your hair to stuff inside Flopsy.
Go away. You're not having any of my hair.
Now, don't be so mean. You can do with a shave, Pom Pom. You've got much too much hair.
No, I haven't. All poodles have a lot of hair. Don't you dare cut it off.
Come on now, just a wee bit.
No!
If you keep saying no, I won't let anyone put your curlers in for you. And by tomorrow morning, your hair will be as straight as a poker.
Oh dear. I wish I wasn't the only poodle in the world with straight hair. All right then. I'll let you cut some of it off, but not too much, or I'll bite you.
While Clinker was cutting Pom Pom's hair, Torchy and the Tingling Bird put the stuffing back inside Flopsy.
There you are. Now you're almost as good as new.
Oh, thank you, Torchy. It was you, kind of.
What did you say?
Said I it was you, kind of.
What a funny way of talking.
I feel most boggle-pickle.
Did you say boggle-pickle or biggle-boggle?
Said I boggle-pickle. I'm front to back.
We've put Flopsy's stuffing in backwards. What a nuisance.
Look at all my lovely curls.
Don't be so bad-tempered. You should be very pleased to help your friend.
Oh, am I going to have the inside stuffing hair yours?
What's Flopsy talking about?
She's talking backwards because her stuffing's back to front.
What a silly rag doll you are.
And you're a poodle silly.
I'm not going to stay here anymore. I can smell a chocolate puddle, and I must find it at once.
Here's the stuffing for Flopsy.
Oh, good. Now, we'll take out the old stuffing and put in the new stuffing. And this time, we'll do it the right way round.
This is the best chocolate puddle I've ever found. And it's a special one, because it's got nuts and raisins in. Oh, I'm going to lick it all up and be sick.
You are not going to lick up all that chocolate. Now stop it at once.
You can't tell me what to do. This is Topsy-Turvy Land.
My goodness, so it is. I'd almost forgotten.
In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can do whatever you want. If you don't eat your greens, then there aren't any seams, and no one says that you can't. In Topsy-Turvy Land, where icing sugar is snow, and there's only one rule that you don't go to school, and no one ever says no. Oh no, one ever says no. Topsy-turvy, everything's front to back. There's no such thing as punishment, and no such thing as a smack. In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can do whatever you please. We have lemonade flowers, you can drink them for hours, and cream buns all grow on trees. In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can play all day in the sun. You don't need a bed, you can stay up instead, and all you do is have fun, 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 and all you do is have fun. Topsy-turvy, everything's upside down. Animals talk and toys can walk in a topsy-turvy town.
I love that song best of all. Let's go home now, and you can put my curlers in.
My arms are too tired from stuffing Flopsy. You better go and ask Clinker to do it for you.
All right,
but I hope he doesn't say no. Dear, kind Clinker, will you put my curlers in?
3 pennies, 2 shillings, 4 sixpences, 1/2 crown and 1/3 piece. That should be enough for dinner. No, I won't put your curlers in. I'm too hungry.
You're woofly mean. You promised to put them in if I let you cut my hair for Flopsy.
Oh, dear, so I did. But I think you should ask Flopsy to do it instead.
All right. And if she says no, I'll pull all her stuffing out again.
Flopsy was in her cherry cottage sewing a dress.
I've got so much stuffy inside me that I'm not half as stuffy as I was. And I can sew much more quickly now. Why, Pom Pom, you brought your curlers.
Will you put them in for me?
Of course I will. You're the kindest poodle in all Topsy-Turvy Land.
Isn't another poodle in Topsy-Turvy Land?
I know. That's why you're the kindest.
You might have a lot of stuffing inside you, Flopsy, but you're as empty-headed as ever.
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, Torchy, Torchy,
there's a twinkling star where all the toys that used to belong to the naughty children live. It is Topsy-Turvy Land, a land where you can do whatever you want.
You can't. In Topsy-Turvy Land, where ice and sugar is snow, and there's only one rule that you don't go to school, and no one ever says no, oh no, oh no, no one ever says no.
Torchy the battery boy is flying in his rocket. He has just taken bad boy Bogey down to Earth and is now on his way back to Topsy-Turvy Land, which is that wonderful big star that twinkles in the sky.
It was very nice to go to Earth again, but it's even nicer to go back to the star. How lucky I am to have this rocket. It flies so fast that I can reach the moon as quickly as someone can walk down to the bottom of the road. Hooray! I can see Topsy-Turvy Land. Now I'll turn the wheel and land in the lollipop field.
Torchy landed in the lollipop field, but there was no one there to meet him because it was late at night.
Toys must be asleep.
sleep, so I'd better go to bed. Won't they be pleased to see me in the morning? Oh, I'm home at last. What a delicious smell. I think I'll go to bed at once.
As Torchy lay in bed, he heard a strange noise.
Whatever can it be? It sounds like the wind, but it can't be. Good gracious! The wind's so fierce that it's shaking my house. Oh, I do hope it stops soon.
But the wind didn't stop, and it went on and on, until all the houses began to tremble, and Flopsy the rag doll came out of Cherry Cottage.
Oh dear! The wiggle-woggle is blowing so hard that I can't sleep. I wish Torchy... Oh! I can see a light in his window.
And then maybe I won't hear the noise of the wind.
Torchy, help me!
That sounds like Flopsy. Whatever is she doing outside so late at night?
Help, help! Torchy, help me!
Why are you lying in the road, Ragdoll?
I can't stand in this wiggle-woggle.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear! I don't think I can either. What can have happened to Topsy-Turvy Land? We've never had a big storm like this before.
Oh, gee, Torchy. I couldn't sleep with this noise going on. It sounds as if we're going to have a hurricane.
Oh, what are we going to do?
I don't know, but when the hurricane blows real hard, cars are lifted in the air, and the houses are knocked over.
We'd better wake all the toys and tell them to go to the caves in the far mountain. The hurricane won't be able to blow the mountain over.
Oh, that's a good idea. I'll go and tell all the toys at once. Come on, everyone!
The toys started to walk to the far mountain.
I'd better hold your hand, Ina, or I'll get blown up into the air!
For goodness sake, be careful, or you might disappear, and I'll never see you again! Oh, Pillywig, I'm so frightened!
Don't cry, Ina! We're nearly at the caves! Come on, Flopsy!
I'm coming. Oh, I've fallen down. Oh, Squish, save me!
Don't worry, Rag Doll. There, you're on the ground again.
Oh, thank you.
Let's try and run the last few yards.
Have you seen Pom Pom?
No, I thought she was with you.
I bet she's still sleeping. That poodle can sleep through anything. I'll have to go back to Fruit Isle and save her.
Bye-bye, Torchy. Do be careful.
Oh, this is terrible. Oh, what a storm. Now, I've got to find Pom Pom's lemon house. Oh, there it is. And it's shaking so much that it might blow into the air at any minute. Oh, that stupid poodle. Why doesn't she wake up? Pom Pom! Wake up!
Why, that's Torchy. What are you doing up so late at night?
Can't you hear the hurricane? Quick, come out!
This is awful. Let me find my ribbon and handbag.
Oh, bother your ribbon and handbag. Come out, I say.
Oh,
body.
And the wind's knocked me silly.
It can't knock you silly. You're silly already.
I'm sorry, Torchy, but when I fall asleep at night... What's happened to my house?
The wind's blown it away. We got out just in time. Now, come on, Pom Pom. Let's go to the caves. We'll be safe there.
This horrible wind is blowing me off my 4 feet.
And I'm so tired, I don't think I can walk anymore. You better go on without me.
Why, I can't leave you here. Let me push you.
It's no use, Pom Pom. I can't walk another step. You go on, and I'll lie under a bush.
But the wind might blow you away. Please try to walk a bit further.
I can't. Do as I say, Pom Pom, and go to the caves.
All right. But I'll bring some of the toys back with me to save you.
Just then, an extra big wind blew along the road and lifted Torchy right up.
Help! Help!
Up and up he went into the air, tossed this way and that.
Thank goodness the other toys are safe! Oh dear, I'll never see them again now! Goodbye, Pom Pom! Goodbye, Flopsy and Squeeze! Goodbye, Pillywig and Ina and Whirly! Goodbye!
Oh, Whirly! Thank goodness I'm here!
Where's Torchy?
He couldn't walk anymore, so I want you to come and help me save him.
I'll get the other toys and go... Oh! Pom Pom! Look! It's Torchy! He's being blown away!
Goodbye, everyone!
What will happen to him?
Torchy was tossed in the air like a leaf. Down, down, down he went. The bulb in his hat broke, and he shook so hard that his battery broke too. Down, down, past the moon and the stars, and all the way to Earth.
What was that noise? Oh, I hope the chimney hasn't blown off. I'd better go into the garden and see. No, it wasn't a chimney after all. Maybe it was a stone. Well, I never! It's Torchy, without his rocket. Oh, how terrible! The wind must have blown him here. Oh, never mind, Torchy. I'll take you inside. There we are. There. So you are, and without your rocket.
It was the big storm. Oh, Mr. Bumbledrop, how am I going to get back to Topsy-Turvy Land again?
No. I'll have to build you another rocket. But don't cry, Torchy. You'll be in Topsy-Turvy Land by next week.
Dear old Bumble Wumble Drop, you're the kindest man in the world.
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, Torchy, Torchy,
you're looking at the Orange Peel Palace, where King Dithers lives. There he is now, on the throne.
Oh, who's waking me up? Oh, why, it's the alarm clock. I put a tea cozy on, but I can still hear the noise. Oh, dear, dear, dear. I suppose I'd better get up and do something, I don't know. Now, where's my crown? Polycan! Polycan, I want my crown!
The polycan bird was in the sentry box. I said, the polycan bird was in the sentry box. Oh, there he is. I hope he can hear the king calling him.
Polycan bird, come here at once.
I'm coming, I'm coming. I can't walk fast on my two flat feet.
You got my crown in your beak. Give it to me.
No, I haven't. You're wearing it.
Wearing it? Oh. Why, so I am. Oh, dear. How dithery I am. Now then, I want to go out for a ride. Tell Daffy to bring my coach.
Very well, Your Majesty. I'll tell him at once. Now where's Daffy and the King's coach?
Here I am.
The King wants you.
Oh, does he? Well, you can tell the king that I'm tired of pulling his coach. It's much too hard for me.
Don't be ridiculous. It's easy to pull a coach.
Aw, you couldn't do it.
Yes, I can. Polly can do anything you can do, and Polly can do it better.
I'm Polycan. Clever Polycan, whatever you can do, Polycan. I'm not a fish, and I'm not a bird. When I sing, it's the funniest thing you've heard. For Polycan keeps everything in his beak. That is why poor Polly can't speak. Minnie Minnie Ma, here we go again. I'm Polycan, clever Polycan. Whatever you can do, Polly can. I'm very ugly, I must admit. When I stand, I look as though I'm going to sit. If you'd got the crown jewels packed inside your beak, you'd know just why poor Polly can't speak.
Now, stop all this singing. Come along, Daffy. I want to go to the far mountain for a ride.
Oh, I'm not taking you. I want to go on the beach and sunbathe.
Good gracious. How dare you do that? Have you forgotten you're the king's donkey?
Oh, I never forget anything. And this morning when I woke up, I remembered it was my birthday. Aww, I'm going to the beach.
Daffy went to the beach and sat down on the sand.
Aww, how lovely to be free. I'll just tilt the umbrella to keep out the sun. And have a sleep.
I'm Pongo, the pirate. I live in a grapefruit sloop. And with my spyglass, I spy and I peer and snoop. I'm Pongo, the pirate. I love to pinch and spank. If I should catch you, I'll make you walk the plank. Pongo bad, Pongo bold. Pongo always looks for gold. Pongo bad, Pongo bold. Pongo always looks for gold.
I don't think I'm going to sail on the sea anymore. I better take my boat into the shore. What's that? Why, it's Daffy. Why aren't you pulling the king's coach?
Aw, it's much too hard for me.
Do you mean you're free?
Yes.
Well, fancy that. Would you like to come and work for me?
Aw, no, I wouldn't. All I'm going to do is to sit in the sun and eat carrots.
Ah, carrots. Thank you for telling me, Daffy. Well, I'm going for a walk, but I'll be back. Don't run away.
Pongo went to the vegetable field and started to dig carrots.
I'll get a wheelbarrow full of the biggest carrots I can find. I'm going to make sure that Daffy works for me. I think, yes, I got enough carrots now. I'll take them back to the beach.
Torchy! Torchy! Oh, there you are. Please, you've got to help me. Daffy's run away.
Where has he gone?
I don't know.
Well, never mind. He'll come back soon.
No, he won't. He's so daffy, he might have lost himself. Put on your magic beam and find him for me.
Well, I don't like using my magic beam too often.
But I'm the king and I'm asking you to.
Very well, Your Majesty. Magic beam that is so bright, will you shine your lovely light? Daffy the donkey is lost, I fear. So find the donkey with a knot in his ear. Now I'll press the switch on my jacket.
Your light is dancing all the way to the beach.
And I can see Daffy with Pongo the pirate.
Giddy up, Daffy!
This grapefruit sloop is much heavier than the king's coach. Oh, I wish I'd stayed with His Majesty.
Well, I'm the king now, and you've got to listen to me.
Leave me alone.
Don't answer me back or I won't give you any carrots. Faster!
Oh, I wish Torchy could save me.
Torchy! Torchy can't save you because he don't know where you are.
How nasty Pongo is. Just wait until I catch hold of him.
Yes, we'll have to think of a special punishment for him.
We must capture him first and make him our prisoner.
Ah, we'll use my elephant trap.
What's that?
It's a big hole that I dug in the wood to catch elephants.
There aren't any elephants in Topsy-Turvy Land.
I know. So we'll catch Pongo instead. Yes, come along and I'll show it to you.
King Dithers showed Torchy and Whirly his elephant trap.
It's very deep and Pongo will never be able to climb out of it on his own. Hello, Pongo, and how are you today?
I'm very well, and what are you so happy about?
I've got lots of things to make me happy. I found some gold. Oh, I didn't mean to say that. I meant I found some cake.
Is that so? Well, come here and talk to me.
Oh, I can't. I've got to go and collect my, my cake.
Well, well. So, Torchy's found some gold, huh? I'll follow him and, borrow it.
Torchy crept through the wood, and Pongo crept after him. Deeper and deeper into the wood they went.
Bushes. Look! Help! Look! Help!
Hooray! We've caught the pirate! Now we'll tie him up and make him our prisoner.
I'll go and rescue poor old Daffy and bring him back to the palace.
And you can tell him I've got a surprise for him. It's a very funny surprise too. Make yourself comfortable, Daffy. I told you I had a surprise for you, didn't I?
Yes, you did. And it makes a wonderful change to sit in a coach instead of having to pull it. Giddy up, Pongo.
Torchy! Torchy! Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, 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 Torchy. Torchy, Torchy,
press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
If you look into the sky at night, you will see a star that twinkles more brightly than any other. It's Topsy-Turvy Land, and all the toys who used to belong to naughty children live there. Torchy, the battery boy, is flying back there now in his rocket.
I'm so excited to see all my friends again. Oh, I can see the lollipop field. I'll turn off the engine and land my rocket there. Late and all the toys are asleep, so I'll go to my pineapple house and go to bed as well.
In the morning, Flopsy the rag doll went out to clean her windows.
What a lovely day it is today. We haven't had any orange juice rain for nearly 3 weeks.
Boop!
Oh! Why, Torchy, I didn't know you were back.
I arrived last night, and I've got lots of wonderful cheeses in my rocket for all the toys.
Oh, good. I love twinkle over cheese. Can we take some to King Dithers as a present?
That's a lovely idea. I'll put a cheese in the wheelbarrow and take it there at once. Gosh, this wheelbarrow is very heavy to push.
Good morning, Torchy. What are you pushing the wheelbarrow for?
I've got some cheese for the king.
Well, I'm not a mouse. I don't want any cheese.
Well, what would you like us to give you?
Christmas pudding. Yes, I love Christmas pudding.
Very well. I'll ask Flopsy to make you one.
So Torchy went back to see Flopsy.
I'm very good at baking, and I'd love to make a pickle popper for the king.
You can't make it in that little bowl. When you give a present to a king, you've got to give him a very big present.
I'll have to get a special mixing bowl, and a lot more flour and fruit.
And we need some money, too. You have to put sixpences in a Christmas pudding, you know. I'll go to the money pile and ask Clinker to give me some. Hello, Clinker. Can you let me have 24 sixpences?
What for? You don't eat money.
We're not going to eat it. We're making a Christmas pudding for King Dithers, and all Christmas puddings have to have money inside them.
24 sixpences is rather a lot.
Oh, don't be mean. I'll put them in.
Fancy taking all those sixpences just to put inside a pudding. Oh dear, what a waste of money it is.
Torchy put all the sixpences into the pudding mixture and Flopsy started to stir it.
Oh, it is hard to stir this pudding. That did look funny with all the sixpences in.
Oh,
what's that noise? It sounds like Clinker. Is that you, Clinker?
No, it isn't.
Oh, good. I must have been imagining it. The pudding's ready now, and I'll go and light the oven.
Thank you.
then, where's the Christmas pudding with my money in? Oh, it's such a big bowl, I can't see over the top of it. I better climb onto the chair. Well, I never. Look at that money. I'm going to take it all back. 1 sixpence. I'll eat that. Another sixpence. And another. I'm going to eat them all up and there won't be any money left in the Christmas pudding. Oh, I can feel a few more sixpences at the very bottom. I'm falling in. Help! Help! Oh, I'm so full of pudding, I can't talk anymore.
Now I'll start to cook the pudding. Oh, it's going to be legal to eat.
Torchy was by the banana bridge with Sparky the dragon.
I wish I had another dragon to play with.
Why can't you find one?
Because I'm the only dragon in the world. And all the other dragons live in the storybooks.
Then you should play with Pom Pom the poodle instead.
I don't like poodles.
Come on, let's go back and get the pudding. Fancy putting a pudding in a wheelbarrow. Flopsy is silly. I'm sure we could have managed to put it on a plate. Oh, goodness. The pudding's much bigger than I thought. We won't even be able to put it on a wheelbarrow.
I've got a good idea. Why don't we use the sledge? We carried the banana bridge on it a long time ago. Don't you remember?
So we did.
The toys put the pudding on the sledge. My goodness, it was heavy.
Now we must push it to the Orange Peel Palace.
It's no good. We'll never be able to push it by ourselves.
We need a donkey.
Well, it's no good asking Daffy. He only likes to pull the king's coach.
I've got a wonderful idea. I want to talk to you, Sparky. Would you like to do something very useful?
Yes, please.
Well, come along and you can be a donkey.
Don't be rude.
Come with me and I'll show you what I mean. There you are, Sparky. I've harnessed you to the sledge and you can pull it all the way to the palace.
Oh, shucks, it's wonderful to be able to do something useful after all. Giddy up, Sparky! Giddy up!
Sparky pulled the sledge all the way down the road until very soon they reached the Orange Peel Palace. King Dithers was sitting on the throne reading a book.
Oh. this is a very peculiar book. Dear. All the writing's upside down. I'll have to stand on my head if I want to read it. Oh, dear. How silly I am. I've got the book in the wrong way up. Oh, dear. I mean, the wrong way down. No, the wrong way up. Oh, dear. I really am dithery.
For I am King Dithers, the dithery king, oh, dithery, dithery day. I often go out when I want to go in. There's no one as silly as me. For I often smile when I ought to frown. And I stand up when I want to sit down. For I am King Dithers, the dithery king, oh, dithery, dithery dee. I drink with a knife and I eat with a spoon. There's no one as silly as me. I haven't a country, I haven't a town. And I'll admit I've lost me crown. And I've even gone out in my dressing gown. I'm Dithers, the dithery king. Oh, why, here's Torchy. What do you want?
Would you like to come outside, Your Majesty? The toys have a surprise for you.
Oh, I love surprises. Yes. My goodness. Oh, what a lovely Christmas pudding. Oh, I hope it's got lots of sixpences in it. I'll get a knife and cut it and we can all have a bit then. Oh, what's happened? Oh, the pudding's alive. My goodness me.
Let me out. Oh, let me out.
Klinker, what are you doing in there?
I was looking for my money. And I fell into the pudding bowl.
Well, well, well. Oh, I like my pudding to have lots of money in, but I don't want it to have a money box. Oh!
Torchy, Torchy. Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I'm a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, 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 boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
Topsy-Turvy Land, some of the toys live in Pooh Town, and some of them live in caves in the far mountain. There's Whirly the Humming Top, and Sparky the Dragon, and lots more.
I don't like playing with you. You always win.
I can't help it. You should learn to play properly.
Oh, no. I should learn to play with someone who's silly.
Bama! Oh, dear, 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 dear.
Sounds like Killy-Golly. Is there anything wrong?
Yes, there is. My hair is so curly that it's always getting into tangles and knots.
Why didn't you use a comb?
That hurts even more. Oh, goodness. What a sight I look.
silly? All gollywogs have curly hair, and all hummingtops are bald. Look at me.
I wouldn't like to be bald, thank you very much, but I would like it to look a bit more tidy.
Why don't you go and ask Torchy to help you? He puts peanut oil on his hair and always looks very smart.
That's a good idea, Sparky. I'll go and see Torchy at once.
Torchy was putting in Pom Pom's curlers.
Don't be careful.
I'm sorry, Pom Pom.
I wish I wasn't the only poodle in the world with straight hair.
So do I. I'm tired of putting in your curlers every night. There, they're all done now.
Thank you. I'll go and have a little walk and see if I can dig up some crispy, crunchy bones. I'm a very pretty poodle. My intelligence is great. And there's only one thing wrong with me. My curly hair is straight. I'm Pom Pom the poodle and I try to please. I like chocolate sauces and always sniff trees. I curl my eyelashes and sharpen my toes and sprinkle black powder on my shiny nose. I'm Pom Pom the poodle, my voice is quite gruff. Although I am tiny, I'm often quite rough. My hair is so straight, I need a permanent wave. And to keep it this shape, I admit that I shave. I'm Pom Pom the poodle.
I think you're very lucky to have straight hair.
Do you?
Yes, I do. My hair is so curly that I can't comb it properly, and I look such a sight. I'm going to see Torchy now and ask him if he can give me some peanut oil to make my hair straight. Goodbye, Pom Pom.
Well, she's a cat around a tree. Fancy not wanting curly hair. I'd give anything in the world if my hair were curly. I'm going to follow Gilly Golly and see what happens. Torchy must have gone out, and that silly gollywog is waiting for him. I can't bear it if Torchy makes Gilly Golly's hair straight. All my life I wanted curly hair. I must go inside and have a look at those lovely black curls. Look at that hair. Such tight curls. If I had hair like Gilly Golly's, I'd never have to put curlers in any more. Ooh, I've a wonderful idea. I'll go and get the scissors. These are lovely big sharp ones. I'd better help Gilly Golly get rid of his curls. But I must do it quickly before Torchy comes back.
Torchy was riding down the road on his penny farthing.
I'm sorry, Burbell.
I don't want to sit on the handlebars yet. I'd like to fly in the sky and stretch my wings.
But you can't do that. I've got to go home.
Oh, yes, I can. Don't you remember that this is Topsy-Turvy Land?
Oh, dear, the tingling bird's quite right, you know. On this twinkling star, no one can tell anyone what to do. In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can do whatever you want. If you don't eat your greens, then there aren't any sins. And no one says that you can't. In Topsy-Turvy Land, where icing sugar is snow. And there's only one rule that you don't go to school. And no one ever says no. Oh no, oh no one ever says no. Topsy-turvy, everything's front to back. There's no
Turvy Land. You can do whatever you please. We have lemonade flowers, you can drink them for hours, and cream buns all grow on trees. In Topsy-Turvy Land, you can play all day in the sun. You don't need a bed, you can stay up instead, and all you do is have fun. And all you do is have fun. Topsy-turvy, everything's upside down. Animals talk and toys can walk in a topsy-turvy town.
I'm back now, Torchy, and I'll sit on the handy bars for you.
Thank you, Bird. Come on, let's go home.
While Torchy was cycling home, Pom-Pom had gone back to her house.
Just look at this curly hair. I'm so excited, I can't stop my tail wagging. What a clever poodle I am. Now I must go and find the glue and stick this lovely hair onto me. Then I'll never need to have curlers. Torchy think I'm clever when he sees me.
But at that moment, Torchy was terribly angry.
Good gracious! Who shaved Gilly Golly's hair off?
I'm sure it was Pom-Pom.
Whatever will Gilly Golly say when he finds out? Gilly Golly, wake up!
Oh, there you are, Torchy. I'm so glad you come back. I want you to give me some peanut oil to make my curly hair straighter. Then I'll be able to brush it properly.
You don't need a brush anymore.
What do you mean? Oh, I got no hair. What's happened to it? I'm bald. Oh, where's my hair?
Pom-Pom's got it.
Why, that wicked poodle. Just wait until I catch her. Come on, Torchy. I'm going around to see her and have a fight.
Pom-Pom was admiring herself in the glass.
If it's a cat, don't come in.
It's not a cat. It's a gollywog.
Oh, hello, Gilly Golly. I'm so excited that I can't help panting. Don't you think I look beautiful?
Why, you just wait until I catch a hold of you.
I thought you'd be pleased. You told me you didn't want curly hair anymore.
No, I didn't. I never said anything of the sort.
You're in a woofly bad temper.
And so would you be if you was bald. Come here, Pom-Pom.
Don't cry, Pom-Pom.
by next week?
I hope so. And as soon as my hair has grown long enough, I'll go down to Earth and maybe Mr. Bumbledrop will take me to the hairdresser's to have a perm.
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I'm a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you'll have seen. Torchy, 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 Torchy.
If you look out of your window on a dark night, you will see a star that twinkles more brightly than any other. And if you could go closer to it, you would see its topsy-turvy land, where all the toys who used to belong to naughty children live. The leader of them is Torchy, and he was made by Mr. Bumbledrop. Torchy also has a rocket, and not long ago, he flew down and brought Mr. Bumbledrop back with him. There they are now, walking into Fruit House.
Well, I've never seen houses made of fruit before. Fancy living in a pineapple.
It's a lot of fun. Flopsy lives in a cherry, and Pom-Pom lives in a lemon.
Oh, I must say, my little woolly Pom-Pom, I've never heard her talk, you know. Please take me to her right away.
Pom-Pom was in her lemon house, making herself look pretty.
My nose is so shiny that I think I'll put some black face powder on it. If you're a cat, don't come in.
I'm not a cat. I'm Torchy, and I've got Mr. Bumbledrop here to see you.
It's awfully nice to see you.
You do sound funny now that you can talk.
Sit down, Master. Would you like a cup of chocolate sauce or a bone to chew?
No, thank you.
Sing your song to Mr. Bumbledrop first. He's never heard it.
Of course I will.
I'm a very pretty poodle. My intelligence is great. And there's only one thing wrong with me. My curly hair is straight. I'm Pom-Pom the poodle and I try to please. I like chocolate sauces and always sniff trees. I curl my eyelashes and sharpen my toes and sprinkle black powder on my shiny nose. I'm Pom-Pom the poodle, my voice is quite gruff. Although I am tiny, I'm often quite rough. My hair is so straight, I need a permanent wave. And to keep me this shape, I admit that I shave. I'm Pom-Pom the poodle.
That was wonderful. I never knew what a clever little poodle you were.
I'll leave you here together. I want to see what's happening on the rest of Topsy-Turvy Land. Well, hello. It's Daffy and King Dithers. What are you doing here?
The king wants to talk to you.
Kneel down when you talk to your king.
But I've never knelt down in front of you before.
Well, it's time you started. Yes. I'm a king, you know, and I want to be treated like a queen. I mean, like a king.
Oh, dear. What are you going to do?
I'm going to make lots of rules. Tell all the toys to be in the throne room this afternoon. I'll have something very important to say to them. Giddy up, Daffy. Back to the palace.
Well, I never. Whatever can have happened to King Dithers? I've never known him behave like that before. I'd better tell the other toys at once.
Later that afternoon, all the toys went to the Orange Peel Palace and into the throne room. There was Pillywig and Ina, Flopsy and Squish, Gilligolly and Whirly, Sparky and Pom Pom, Torchy and Mr. Bumbledrop, and Daffy.
The king isn't on the throne. Where can he be?
Oh, yes. Here comes His Majesty King Dithers.
Good afternoon, everybody. Yes. I'm going to make some changes in Topsy-Turvy Land.
What sort of changes?
It's no longer going to be the land where you can do whatever you want. No, it's going to be the land where you must do whatever I want. No. Don't make such a noise. You've got to listen to me because I'm the king. Pollikin Bird, where are all the rules that I wrote down this morning?
You're sitting on them.
Oh, dear. So I am. Rule one. No more cream buns or lollipops are to be picked without my permission.
And when will you give us permission?
Be quiet, why, His Majesty the King.
What will you do if we don't obey you?
I'll go to prison. No. I mean, you'll go to prison. Yes. Rules number 2, 3, 4, and 5. The only food you're allowed to eat is cabbage and spinach. Yes, you've got to wash your neck and ears 3 times a day, and you've got to be in bed by 5:30. Now then, go back to Fruit Town and be very, very, very good.
I don't know what's happened to King Dithers, but I think we should knock him off the throne.
So do I. He can't tell us what to do.
We'd better capture him and make him our prisoner.
That's a good idea. We'll lock him in his own dungeon.
Then we'll have a new king.
Who shall it be?
Why don't you be King, Torchy?
Oh, no. I wouldn't like to wear such a heavy crown.
I'll have a spin and think. I always think better when I'm spinning.
Whirly spun round and round.
Have you thought of anything yet?
Yes. I have a wonderful idea.
What is it?
We'll make Mr. Bumbledrop the king.
That's a super-duper idea.
And I'll go and tell Mr. Bumbledrop at once.
Torchy asked Mr. Bumbledrop to be the king of Topsy-Turvy Land.
Oh, but I wouldn't be at all comfortable living in a palace.
Oh, dear, Mr. Bumblewumbledrop, you can't refuse. All the toys will be so unhappy.
Very well. I'll do it.
Good. Now we'll capture King Dithers and lock him up.
King Dithers was having a ride in his coach.
Thank you.
faster, Daffy. Giddy up, giddy up, Daffy.
I can't go faster. This coach is heavy, and I'm a little donkey.
If you don't go faster, I'll smack you.
Stop! Stop!
Move out of the way!
No, I won't!
How dare you disobey me? I'll lock you up in my dungeon.
All right!
Good gracious. Do you mean you want to be locked up?
Yes, I do.
Oh. How peculiar. Well, come along then, and I'll lock you up at once.
Something must be the matter with Torchy. He's as stupid as a donkey.
King Dithers took Torchy to the dungeon.
Here we are. Now I'll lock me up. I mean you up. Help! Help! Let me in! Let me in! I mean, let me out! Let me out!
It feels very strange to be a king. Eh? Well, what do you want me to do?
We want you to be as nice as King Dithers used to be.
He was always saying dithery things and making us laugh.
Well, I'm afraid that I can't say dithery things to make you laugh, because I'm not a dithery man.
What a shame.
Ah, yes, it is. In fact, I don't want to be a king, Torchy. Let me go and talk to Dithers. Maybe I can make him be nice and kind again. Now then, King Dithers, why have you behaved so badly? You used to be good and kind.
Oh, I know I was. Yes, but I got tired of all the toys laughing at me because I was so dithery. That's when I decided I was going to be strict.
But the toys only laughed at you because they loved you. And you've made them very unhappy.
Oh, dear. Oh, have I really? Oh, no. Oh, I'm unhappy too because, you know, I love the toys.
Well, if I let you out of prison, will you promise to be a good king?
Oh, I certainly will. Yes. Please close the door and let me in. I mean, open the door and let me in. Out.
All right. And I'll give you back your crown as well.
King Dithers sat on his throne again.
Now then, I just wanted to let you know that you can do whatever you want. Yes. And if you don't want to take any notice of me, I won't mind.
We'll always take notice of you as long as you're kind. Three cheers for King Dithers.
Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you'll have seen. Torchy, my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
There are many wonderful things in Topsy-Turvy Land, which is really a twinkling star in the sky. All the toys who used to belong to naughty children live there, and they never want to go back to Earth, because in Topsy-Turvy Land, they have a lollipop field, a bullseye bush, a peanut tree, and a lemonade lily. Mr. Bumbledrop is on Topsy-Turvy Land, and Torchy brought him there in his rocket.
What a wonderful place Topsy-Turvy Land is. Just look at this cream bun tree. No matter how many you pick, the branches are never empty. I've eaten so many cream buns myself that I could do with a drink. Ah, here's a lemonade lily. Yes, I'll pump the leaf up and down and the lily will fill with lemonade. That was very tasty. Yes, I could stay here forever. Except that I miss my own home and my comfortable armchair. I'll go to Frowtown and ask Torchy to take me back to Earth. Pom Pom! Good gracious! My poodle's wearing a hat. Get down on all fours, you silly dog.
I'm not a silly dog. I'm a pretty poodle. Don't you like my hat? It's a French berry.
But you are not French.
That's a wonderful thing to say. I'm a French poodle, and I think I will talk with a French accent.
Oh. You're the funniest dog in the world. Will you come back to Earth with me?
Please stay here instead. Please, please. I love you.
And I love you. But I've got to go home. Do you know where Torchy is?
He's at home doing something exciting. Go and see for yourself.
Although pineapples are yellow inside, I'm going to paint my pineapple pink.
You can't have a pink pineapple.
Yes, I can. Topsy-Turvy Land is the land where you can do whatever you like. There's a can of pink paint on the floor, so you can help me.
This is exciting. I love painting, you know.
Pillywig and Ina were quarreling in the playground.
I've never seen such a ridiculous scarf. Why did you make it so long?
Because you've got a long tooth.
But I don't want a scarf for my tooth.
Hi, Pillywig. Hi, Ina.
Look, every time I walk, I'll fall over and hurt myself.
Oh, that's terrible.
It's nothing to laugh at.
I'm not laughing. I'm crying. Dogs bark, cats meow, and hyenas can only laugh.
Well, I'm getting tired of you laughing.
Don't be cross with Ina.
But I can't help being cross with Ina. I do wish she'd stop laughing. I'm going to see Torchy. Maybe he can give her some medicine that will make her cry instead.
Oh, my house is going to look beautiful. I love sloshing on the paint. Up goes the brush and down goes the brush. Oh, I've dropped it.
You stupid thing! Look what you've done to my suit!
Well, I didn't see you coming in.
Haven't you got eyes? Oh, dear. Look, now I'll have to wash my suit. And I haven't got another one to wear. Oh, dear, 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 dear.
I'm sorry.
Pillywig ran back to the playground, where Ina was crying.
Because I haven't anything else to wear.
You'll have to wrap yourself in the scarf. I'll get the washing tub ready and come back for the suit. How much starch should I use? Good morning, Flopsy. I want to do some washing, and I don't know how much starch to use.
1 teaspoon to a pickle-pockle of water.
Thank you.
But don't use more than 1 teaspoon to a pickle-pockle, because if you do, the starch will make the clothes very stiff.
I'll be most careful. Bye-bye. Now then, 1 teaspoon of starch to a pickle-pockle of water. what is a pickle-pockle of water? Is a pickle-pockle of water a cup of water or a wash tub full? I'd better put in the whole packet of starch, just to make sure. I want Pillywig's suit to be extra specially beautiful. There we are.
Ina washed the suit and hung it on the line.
There we are. It'll be dry in a few minutes. Now I'll go and ask Torchy to come to a party this afternoon. I must have a party now the Pillywig is my friend again.
Torchy and Mr. Bumbledrop were just going into the rocket when Ina called them.
Don't go down to Earth today, Torchy. I'm giving a party.
I love parties. Please, Mr. Bumbledrop, can we go back to Earth later on tonight?
Yeah, I suppose so. But I'm too old and tired to walk all the way to Fruit Town again. I'll stay here and wait for you to come back.
You can't leave Mr. Bumbledrop here. Why don't you go and fetch your bicycle and, and carry him back?
That's a good idea. I'll bring my bicycle at once.
Torchy went for his bike and rode all the way back to the rocket.
Ina's giving us a party this afternoon, Tingling Bird. Aren't you pleased?
I'd be much more pleased if you didn't tap me so hard every time you wanted to ring the bell.
I'm sorry, Bird, but when I go to Earth again, I must remember to bring back a proper bell, and then I won't need to use you.
I've got a penny farthing and it's going very fast. I ride the pedals round and see the trees go whizzing past. When I go ding ding on the ting-a-ling, all the toys around can tell that the ting-a-ling will soon sing, sing, sing and sound just like a bell. I've got a penny farthing with a wheel both big and small, and when I ride upon my bike then I am very tall. Though I have no bell, I have got a bird and his name is Ting-a-ling. When I tap his tail he lets out a wail, then he begins to sing.
Torchy cycled down the road again, and they were nearly at Fruithorn when they heard Ina and Pillywig shouting at one another.
What a stupid hyena you are! I can't wear my suit now! You've put too much starch in it!
It's not my fault! I wanted it to be extra special!
Well, it's extra special stiff. Look at it. Standing up on its own. Why, it could even walk by itself when the wind blows.
It does look funny.
Yes. It does, doesn't it? Quite funny!
What's the matter, Pillywig? I heard you... Oh, look!
Pillywig, how funny you are to make your suit walk on its own. I think you're the funniest clown in Topsy-Turvy Land.
Oh, do you really? Well, it was Ina's idea, you know.
Oh, Ina, we'll have to make you a clown as well.
What a good idea! I'll ask Flopsy to make Pillywig and me two new clown suits.
Yes, and we can wear them when you come to the party this afternoon.
Oh, look, Pillywig and Ina. How funny they look.
I'm so happy in my new suit because it suits me.
And I'm so happy because you're so happy that you're so happy. Now, let's start the picnic, everybody. Have a clean bun, Pillywig.
What did you do that for?
Because there are two clowns on Topsy-Turvy Land now.
Torchy, 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 the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy, Torchy, Torchy,
Daffy the donkey was cleaning the king's coach outside the king's palace.
Aww. I don't want to clean the king's coach anymore. Aww. I want to go and live on my own and have no one tell me what to do.
What are you grumbling about?
Aww. I'm not grumbling, but this is Topsy-Turvy Land. The land where you can do whatever you want, and I want to be free.
Well, you'd better go and tell King Dithers. He's in the kitchen making some jam tarts.
I love cooking, and I've nearly finished these tarts. Now I'll put the pastry on the bottles of jam. And, oh, I wonder if that's right. Oh, no, I'm sure it isn't.
Aww. What's the matter, Your Majesty?
Well, I've forgotten how to make jam tarts. Do you remember?
Of course. Elephants forget, you know. But donkeys always remember.
Ah, yes. But you've forgotten something now.
What?
Your umbrella. You usually keep it on your tail.
I took it off because I was dusting your coach.
Hurry back. I want to talk to you.
I'm not coming back. I'm never going to work for you anymore.
Well, I never. What an obstinate donkey that donkey is.
Daffy went outside to find his umbrella.
Aw, I know I left it by the coach. Aw, it's disappeared.
I saw Pongo the pirate sneaking outside the palace a little while ago. Maybe he's taken it.
Oh, dear. That wicked pirate is always stealing things. I'd better go and find him.
Pongo the pirate was walking along the road with Daffy's umbrella.
It was lucky that I was walking past the palace and found this lovely umbrella. I picked it up and borrowed it. And I'm going to take it back to my boat. But before I do, I think I go to Froo Town and get some food.
Pongo reached Flopsy's cherry cottage and knocked on the door.
Oh, what do you want?
I'd like some cream buns and lollipops, carrots and cabbage. And if you won't give me some, I'll come into your house and take it myself.
Oh, have you got a basket for me to put it in?
No, but you can tip it into the umbrella. Now, while I'm waiting, I'll go and see what Pom Pom's doing. I fancy teasing a dog for a change.
I love crispy, crunchy bones.
What's the matter with you?
Dogs don't like anyone bending over them when they're chewing a bone. Move away, or I'll give you a bite.
No. There's a good dog. There's a pretty poodle.
Do you really think I'm pretty?
Of course I do. You got beautiful hair, beautiful eyes, and a beautiful voice.
Then I'll sing to you.
Oh, dear, I was afraid of that.
All our town is made of fruit, just take a peep and see. Apples and pears and juicy cherries, red can be. Gooseberry chairs, walnut stairs. We can munch a lemon door, or lickety-lack a blackcurrant floor. So if you will come to Fruit Town, there's a pretty sight. If you're good, then I will promise you a great big bite. Oranges, golden plums, cherries ripe and red. And if you want to eat them up, we'll pick some more instead. All our town is made of fruit, just take a peep and see. Apples and pears and juicy cherries, red as red can be. There! Did you like that?
No, I didn't. This is lovely. Now I'll take it back to my boat. My goodness, that umbrella was very heavy to carry. Now I'll tip all the food into my...
Well, what's this? Gaw, I can see an hole in the side of my boat. Oh dear, I'd better mend it with some glue.
Where's my umbrella?
Oh dear, I don't think I'd better stay on the beach after all. I don't want to fight a donkey.
Just wait until I find out who's taken my umbrella. Well, I never. There's Pongo sailing on the sea. But he hasn't got a boat. He's got my umbrella instead.
Yo-ho, and a bottle of milk. Daffy won't be able to catch me now. Goodbye, Daffy!
Give me back my umbrella. Oh, dear. Whatever can I do? What a miserable donkey I am.
Hello, Daffy. What's the matter with you?
Pongo's got my umbrella.
Why don't you go back to King Dithers? Maybe he's got another umbrella for you.
I'm not going to work for the king anymore. I want to have some fun.
Well, let's go and play in the lollipop field.
No. Donkeys don't like to play hide and seek, or tag, or hopscotch.
What do donkeys like to do?
Well, donkeys like to, donkeys like to behave like horses. We're very close relations, you know. Horses are my first cousins.
Very well, then. If you're going to be a horse, I'm going to ride on you. Kneel down and let me climb on your back. Oh, this is fun.
It might be fun for you, but it isn't fun for me. Get
off. No.
Then I'll throw you off.
Be careful.
Get off. Now go away and leave me alone. I want my umbrella.
Don't cry, Daffy. I think I know how I can get your umbrella back. You go and hide so that Pongo can't see you.
All right.
Pongo! Dear kind Pongo, I'd like to talk to you.
I wonder what Torchy wants. I bet he's up to some nasty trick. What do you want?
Your boat is broken again. You can't mend a hole just by sticking a piece of glue onto it. You've got to put another little bit of grapefruit skin there instead.
Well, I never thought of that. Thank you, Torchy. Is the donkey there?
No, he isn't. It's quite safe for you to come back.
Pongo came back to the beach, and Torchy gave him a little bit of grapefruit skin to mend the hole in his boat.
You need a special kind of paste that's extra sticky. Ordinary glue will wash off in seawater.
Is that so? You were very kind for telling me all this. Where is this special paste?
Well, I've rubbed it on the hole already. You just put this little bit of grapefruit skin over it, and you'll be able to sail out to sea.
Thank you very much indeed. I want my umbrella.
Well, why don't you sail the boat a little bit first and then come back for the umbrella?
All right. Will you wait here and look after it for me? I don't want Daffy to find it.
I'll guard it very carefully.
Pongo went for a little sail, and then a strange thing began to happen.
I don't think the special paste that Torchy gave me is any good. The hole in my boat has come back again. And all the water's pouring in. What can I do to stop the hole? Oh, dear. This is terrible.
I've got my umbrella back, thanks to you. I think I'd better return to the palace after all. It's much safer for donkeys to pull coaches. Bye-bye, Torchy.
Bye-bye, Daffy.
Daffy went back to the Orange Peel Palace and harnessed himself to the king's coach.
Goodness me, Daffy. I thought you'd run away.
I've changed my mind. I feel much safer with you, Your Majesty. I learned something very important today when I was free.
Did you really? What was that?
I learned that I was just a donkey.
Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I'm a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. See my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen.
Mr. Bumbledrop was digging in his garden and thinking about the twinkling star, where all the toys live who used to belong to naughty children.
I wish Pum-Pum would come down and live with me for a change. I'm lonely by myself.
Poor Mr. Bumbledrop. I think Pum-Pum's very mean not to come and see you.
Well, I don't blame her. You see, she has a wonderful time on Topsy-Turvy Land.
Our town is made of fruit, just take a peep and see. Apples and pears and juicy cherries, red as red can be. Gooseberry chairs, walnut stairs. We can munch a lemon door, or lickety-lack a blackcurrant flower. So if you will come to Fruit Town, there's a pretty sight. If you're good, then I will promise you a great big bite.
Oh, dear. My house looks dirty. I'd better lick it clean. Dear kind Squish, will you please clean my lemon house?
Okay. I'll squish some water on it with my water pistol.
Thank you.
Come on, Pom-Pom. Now then. You stand out of the way, and I'll squirt the water.
Well, I'd better go inside. I don't want to get wet, or my curls will come out.
Okay.
How kind Squish is to help me. I'll give him a bone as a present. My lemon is going to be the cleanest house in Fruit Town. Oh, I am pleased. Have you finished yet, Squish?
Now I've squirted water on you.
You horrid toy! What was that? What? Sniff a lamppost. Why am I making such a peculiar noise? I'd better go and ask Torchy if he knows what it is. Can you help me, Torchy? I keep making these strange...
my hiccups.
But you've got to do something. I can't eat if I keep hiccuping all the time.
Of course you can eat. Look, I can see a lovely chocolate puddle. Come over with me and lick it up.
It's no good, Torchy. Every time I lick a bit of chocolate, I hiccup it up again. Please make me better.
Don't cry, Pom-Pom. I'll go to the cave in the far mountain and see if Whirly can help you.
Torchy cycled on his penny farthing to the far mountain. Before he got there, he saw Whirly spinning in front of him.
Hello, Whirly. I want to talk to you.
What do you want?
Do you know how I can cure Pom-Pom's hiccups? Please stop spinning and help me.
I always think better when I'm spinning. There isn't a cure for hiccups, I'm afraid. The only thing to do is to hold your breath and count 100.
Thank you, Whirly. I'll make Pom-Pom do that right away. Bye-bye. Now then, Pom-Pom, you've got to hold your breath and count to 100.
I can't.
Well, don't be silly. Of course you can. It's very easy to hold your breath.
What a stupid toy you are! Of course I can hold my breath, but I can't count!
Good gracious, I didn't know that! Well, I'll write the numbers down for you, and you can read them aloud.
I can't read either! Can't I do something else to get rid of these nasty hiccups?
I can't think of anything, Pom-Pom!
Switch on your magic beam! I'm sure it'll be able to help me.
All right, then. Magic beam that is so bright, will you shine your lovely light? The chocolate puddles Pom-Pom can't lick up until you take away that nasty hiccup. Now, I'll press the switch on my jacket and see what happens.
Oh, the beam in your hat is getting brighter.
And it's shining all the way down to Earth and onto Bossy Boots' house.
I feel so sorry for Mr. Bumbledrop, Mummy. He's very lonely by himself.
But what's happened to his dog?
Pom-Pom lives on the Twinkling Star.
You mean she's run away and got lost?
No, no, she isn't lost. She lives on the Twinkling Star.
Oh, how you children do talk. You're always imagining things.
I'm not imagining things, Mummy. And Mr. Bumbledrop is so lonely, I want to go and keep him company.
Oh, he doesn't want to be bothered with little girls.
I'm not going to be a little girl. I'm going to pretend I'm a dog.
Oh, Bossy Boots, you are funny. Don't forget to come back in time to go to bed.
I won't. Ruff, ruff. Bye-bye.
Mr. Bumbledrop was sitting in his chair when Bossy Boots came in.
Ruff, ruff, Mr. Bumbledrop. I'm going to be your little dog, and you won't be lonely anymore.
That's a fine idea. Your basket's all ready for you.
It's not very comfortable in here. Ruff, ruff. Have you got a pillow?
Dogs don't have pillows.
Oh. Well, can I have a book to read?
Dogs can't read.
Oh, well, what do they do with themselves?
They just follow their master.
Oh, I wouldn't like to live a dog's life.
Well, I thought you'd change your mind. Come on, Bossy Boots. I've got a lovely glass of lemonade and a cream cake for you.
Oh, how lovely. I'm ever so thirsty.
Don't drink it too quickly, or you'll get the hiccups.
No, I won't. I never get the... Oh, dear. I have got them.
Ah, poor Bossy Boots. I know a wonderful way of getting rid of hiccups. Go out into the garden and stand by the tree.
On Topsy-Turvy Land, Pom Pom and Torchy were watching Mr. Bumbledrop very carefully.
If my master can get rid of Bossy Boots' hiccups, then you will know how to get rid of mine.
Shh! I'm listening. Where can Mr. Bumbledrop be? Oh, I don't like standing out here on my own.
Boo!
Oh, what a fright you gave me! It's a very mean thing to do, Mr. Bumbledrop, and I'm not going to stay here with you anymore.
No. I gave you a fright on purpose.
What for?
Because that's the best way of getting rid of the hiccups.
Oh, well, fancy that. Thank you so much.
And I thank you too, dear old Bumble Wumble Drop. Bye-bye.
Now then, Pom Pom, I'm going to give you a fright.
What sort of a fright?
Well, if I told you, it wouldn't be a fright anymore. I'm going home to think of something.
Well, don't be too long, will you?
You gave Pom Pom such a fright with your water pistol that she's got the hiccups. And you must help me to give her another fright that will take her hiccups away.
Oh, this sounds as if it's going to be fun. What do I have to do?
I thought we'd make a booby trap. We'll fill a sack with flour and put it on top of the door. And then when Pom Pom comes in, it'll fall all over her and give her such a fright that she won't hiccup anymore.
Gee, that sounds super. Let's fix it right away.
There we are. We've got the sack on top of the door, and when Pom Pom pushes it open, it'll fall on her.
How will she know to come here?
Well, you better go and tell her.
I don't want to go out of the door, or the sack will fall on me.
Then climb through the window. Hurry, Squish. I can't wait.
Come on, Pom Pom. Torchy wants you.
Does he? That means he's got a fright for me. What are you laughing at?
Just wait and see. Come on in, Pom Pom.
Oh!
What's happened?
You got the fright instead of me! I've never laughed so much in all my life!
Silly Squish, you forgot all about the booby trap.
I know I did. Oh, now we'll have to give Pom Pom another fright.
No, you won't. I've laughed so much that my hiccups have gone.
Torchy, the little battery boy. I'm a clever walkie-talkie toy with bright blue eyes and golden hair. I've a magic beam that can shine anywhere. Torchy, the little battery boy. Torchy, the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Torchy,
the battery boy. I'm a walkie-talkie toy. Press my switch, see my bulb start to gleam. It's the most magic light you have seen. Thank you.